Today it is probably minus 3 degrees Fahrenheit outside, and it is mid-February at Peacock Park. And I have a group of friends coming over today, and we're gonna do craft class. So I figured to feed all these hungry people, I am going to make my favorite soup. It's butternut squash soup, but what's so fantastic about it, it is so super simple. I'm not a great chef. I don't claim to be a great chef, but sometimes it appears that I am only when I can make super cool dishes like this one. So what this one entails is so easy. There's so few little ingredients. There's butternut squash, obviously, some onion, garlic, cream, vegetable broth if you want to make it sheer vegetarian, or you can use chicken broth if you really don't, if that's not a preference to you. Then just a few simple things like salt, a tiny bit of pepper, because I don't care for pepper. So I mean like a minuscule amount of that, and a little bit of nutmeg just scraped in there too. And basically that's it. I do add a little bit of white wine, and that adds a little bit of flavor to it as well. That's all your ingredients. And then I'll show you how easy it is to put it all together. So, the first thing you need to do is cut the butternut squash into chunks. And the best thing that I do is I cut the bottom off so that you can stand it up on end, and then you literally slice down the sides so that you get rid of the flesh. From there, I cut it in half, I scoop out the seeds, and then I just basically just cut it all into chunks. It doesn't matter what size, they're all gonna be roasted anyway. So anything conforming in a couple inch square cubes, that's fine. And then what I do is I just cut an onion, just cut the top off real roughly, cut it. Cut the top, cut the bottom, do it in the same size chunks, and that's it for the onion. Garlic. There's a couple ways you can do garlic. I personally like to take the skin off first, and or you can roast it, which we all know it squeezes out really easy after it's roasted, but I prefer to just knock it off, and it's really easy. You just put down your garlic, you put your knife end over the top, the flat edge, and literally just put your weight into it, and you hear that crunch, and that just means that it pops right out of its little skin, and then it goes into the oven with that. So with the butternut squash, the easiest way I have found, I cut the bottom end off so that it can stand up. And then of course you want to cut the top off as well. So once you get rid of that, and actually it's hard to believe, but you can just use a peeler. If you just use a peeler, you can get that skin off so easy because it's thin, but it's tough. So that's the fastest way. And that way you can whip through this thing and get it in the oven. Seriously, your prep time on this entire meal should be no more than 10 minutes. So once you have everything chopped up into chunks, all you do is put it on a baking sheet, throw it, all of it, chunks, you just mix it up, no rhyme or reason, throw it down on there and add drizzle olive oil over the top, and then toss it all and throw it in the oven to roast. And I roast it at 350 for about 45 minutes and check it. As soon as everything's tender, and I like it to get a little brown, a little caramelized, if you like that roasted flavor, let it go that far. If you don't, you can pull it out as soon as it's tender. But personally, I like that heavy roasted, kind of makes it a nutty flavor. But that's personally what I like. So after everything's all rolled in the oil and gushy and gross, I throw it in the oven and forget about it for about almost an hour. I told you, this is so easy. Really? You're over halfway home, and that's all you had to do so far. I call it a super simple soup, if you ask me. This has been in here about 50 minutes, and it is looking fabulous. This is what I like when it gets that brown, little bit of brown crunchiness on it. It can go a little bit further. It gets that more of a roasted feel to it. But actually, because everyone's gonna be here in literally 25 minutes. I think I'm gonna just yank it now. It's certainly done. It's done enough to make the soup for sure. Now that it's all cooked and it's pretty good, see, one of these little garlics got in there without its being peeled. So once, if you throw them in that way, it literally comes right out of its skin. I've done that. I've jumped out of my skin a couple times. It's time for the garlic to do that. Okay, so now, really, this is what you do. Take all this goodness. I typically use an immersion blender, but I'm gonna show you it this way because a lot of people don't have an immersion blender, which is, it looks like a wand. You stick it in the pan, turn it on, and it mixes it from the bottom of the pan. But everybody has a blender. So I'm gonna make this in a blender. May have to make it in a couple batches, but that's fine. It's all good, and it's all the same, and it's all so easy. Okay, this is like ridiculous how simple this is. Add a little bit of salt, okay? Not a ton, just like that, and like that, like so. 2 pinches is plenty. I'm gonna make this, I left half there, I'm gonna make the other half after. You put in, I have about 1.5 cans of chicken broth, and this is strictly by sight. I don't really have a true measurement. Just fill it up a quarter of the way with this. And this, I first get this like a thick puree. And this is gonna be loud. This is where. Now, I take cream and use heavy whipping cream, strictly drizzle it in like that much. I like a lot of cream, but to each their own. I feel like creamier the better. Basically, mix this up and get the cream blended in, and you can even fold the cream in so you can keep it on a thick consistency, or if you want a creamier soup, like right now, this is its consistency. It's a little bit thick. So everybody likes it a little bit different. And all you do is slowly just keep adding a little bit of the broth, and I'm gonna get it right now to the consistency. I'm gonna get it right now how we want it. Oh, I'm kidding. It's amazing. Okay, so the soup is all done, and here it is. It is just a crusty toast with croutons, and I did add a little bit of chunk in it, and everyone's gonna be served in their own little pewter pot. So that's the way it's gonna be served, and that's for what's for lunch here at Peacock Park on Craft Day.